Hello, welcome in Radio Khanch 90.4 FM. I am Dr. Sunil Kumar Jha. Today I am with Opine that I will discuss the solid waste management, which is the syllabus content of fourth semester of students of biotechnology under the environmental biotechnology. Here I shall discuss what is waste, when waste become pollutant, hazard by solid waste, its source of solid waste, how to handle the solid waste problem. India generates around 1,50,000 tons of municipal solid waste every day. Large cities like New Delhi and Mumbai generates around 8,500 tons of waste per day. India suffers from inefficient and insufficient waste infrastructure and also increasing rates of generation per capita. Responsibility of urban waste bodies is to handle the waste. Trinamulai in Tamil Nadu, having 100% composting facility in their own backyard. These days, a term is prevalent in solid waste, it is not in my backyard, as the local citizens opposes the civic projects like jail, garbage, dump or drug rehabilitation center, though needed by the large community, it is considered unsightly or dangerous and decrease property value. In the same way, they opposes the dumping of solid waste in their backyard. Decentralized solid waste management these days is oftenly used, which provide a clean environment and an hygienic living condition by reducing the quantity of at source. It involves the management of municipal solid waste by various small waste management center within their locality. This is the concept of decentralized waste management system. Basel Convention 1989 prevention of dumping hazardous waste from rich nation to African or underdeveloped country. It is prevention. Anything which cannot be used further for any profitable purpose is waste. When waste start creating a harm to environmental component like air, water and soil, and their biotic or abiotic component, it becomes a pollutant. Waste material is being produced as a result of human activity. These waste, when remain in solid, they are called solid waste. At first instance, when the waste are normally solid and result in landscape pollution, the term refuse is oftenly used interchangeably with the term solid waste. The term solid waste encompasses the highly heterogeneous mass of discarded material or throw away from the urban communities, that is residential and commercial activities, as well as the more homogeneous accumulation of waste generated by agriculture and industrial activities. Waste can be classified in the following categories as garbage or food waste. These are the meat, fish, fruit, vegetable residue which decompose rapidly, especially in warm weather. Second is rubbish, which do not decompose rapidly. They may be combustible like paper, cardboard, textile, rubber, leather, plastic, and non-combustible like crockery, metal, aluminium cans, tin cans, empty glass bottles. In agriculture waste, jute, cotton, tea, coffee, coconut, sugar cane, straw, farm manure, cattle shed waste mostly come from crop residue of agriculture field. Industrial waste like fly ash, chemical, sludge, paint, toxic metal. Hazardous waste like radioactive waste, toxic chemicals, flammable waste, explosive, hazardous waste from hospital or research institutions. Pathological waste, example, carcass of animals, slaughterhouse waste, blood, piece of meat, hair, fat, bone chippings, skins. In solid waste, demolition and construction of waste, stones, construction waste, stones, bricks, dust, plaster, sanitary parts. Under electronic waste, electronic switches, mobile, computer, motor parts, generator parts come. Altogether, we can say solid waste is the single largest source of non-point air and water pollution. These waste pollute air, water, and even soil. Solid waste contribute to environmental pollution is no less in any way. Piled up at public places cause obstruction in daily life, but due to enormous size of our population, quantum of waste is large. Although we utilize the conventional, that is landfilling method to decompose waste, but it is unhygienic. National Committee on Science and Technology one time said the utilization and recycling of the above waste, utilization and recycling would have three benefits. Natural resources would be conserved, production cost would be reduced, pollution problem would also be solved. We will astonished to notice, in spite of efforts are made to recycle waste, but the varied and voluminous waste, about 200 billion metal, glass, plastic, food, beverage container, every year comes in trash at waste place. Waste separation entails separating according to pollution board has also suggested three colors of dustbins: green for biodegradable waste, black for electronic waste, blue for plastic and metal waste. This practice will separate solid waste from liquid or gas. A number of waste separation technologies are developed, like air stripping, that force to make liquid like petrol, alcohol, sodium, spirit, perfume, to vaporize them after making air passes over them. In separation technology is steam stripping. In this, heated air will force the liquid to form vapor to volatile liquid, or bypass them over containers of activated charcoals. Thermal treatment, heating the waste over very high temperature. This will destroy 99.9% of organic waste, but cost is very high. But at the same time, incinerator may be an energy recovery technology, as it generates much energy and overpower energy deficit problem. Incinerator will reduce the area of landfill needed to waste management. Prevent method of waste disposal is prevalent method of waste disposal is open dump. This takes time in sorting the garbage from edible or recyclable material. Ocean dumping, we cannot continue to treat ocean as a place of garbage disposal. Landfill, it must be away from residential locality. Landfill may leach down and may pollute the water table. Reuse. Remembering one thing that modern waste management suggests, the three R: reduction, reuse, recycle. As already several times discussed, that streams from food, textile, vegetable matter, oil, and other biodegradable material, energy can be extracted from these waste. Microorganisms which decompose in landfill generates billion of cubic meter of methane, which is called natural gas. If we will not utilize this energy, then it will contribute to global warming. Many countries drilling methane wells in their landfills. So we, the underdeveloped country, can do. Organic material should be burnt in an incinerator rather than being buried in landfills. But incinerators have many chances of air pollution. Therefore, anaerobic digestion is the process by which organic matter such as animal or food waste is broken down to produce biogas and biofertilizer. This process happens in the absence of oxygen in a sealed oxygen-free tank called anaerobic digester. Methane, natural gas, can be extracted from anaerobic digester. Through composting, organic matter produces soil conditioner as it is rich in nutrient. First, most of the cellulose breaks by action of fungi and yeast, then bacteria works upon them and many more complex polymer of organic matter being degraded. In bioremediation, oxygen and microorganism are injected into contaminated zone. The organism feed on oxygen and eliminate the pollutants and then die when the pollutants are gone. Thank you.